pretending to be Dodge's dad, but it was a lot easier than telling a little kid that his real father was a random loser from a Ronnie James Dio concert. Made fun of people with accents. Snatched the kid's Halloween candy when he came to my trailer to trick or treat.
Excuse me, Mr. Hickey, but I believe that was me.
The accent or the candy? Tell you what, come see me after class. Any questions?
Dodge's mom's married to a black man. I've seen him.
Where are you going with this, sweetie?
Why don't you have Dodge every weekend like all the other divorced dads? Because last weekend, Dodge came to my birthday party and the black guy dropped him off.
Why don't I live with you on weekends? Don't you like me?
Yeah, I like you, of course. I just don't want to get in Darnell's way because he's your stepdad and he really, really likes you. Plus, you already live with him. So maybe you should start shifting your love in that direction.
Burn.
Joy, this isn't fair to Dodge. He was embarrassed, I was embarrassed.
You should be embarrassed. Where'd you buy that sweater, Jacruz?
I'm serious, Joy. You should have seen the looks we were getting from those two mommy daddies. And the British kid said my parenting was bollocks. You have to tell Dodge the truth.
You think he'll feel better when he finds out his daddy's some random drunk at a Molly Hatchet concert?
You mean Ronnie James Dio. You've always said it was a Ronnie James Dio concert.
Molly Hatchet, Ronnie James Dio. All I remember is we were in the men's room, it was crowded, and it's hard to get my leather pants off in that itty-bitty stall.
Hold on. You said it happened under the concession stand while you were kneeling on a box of cups and he continued selling nachos.
I didn't say that.
Yes, you did. Remember I asked you if a parent-teacher conference was an appropriate place to tell this story?
Joy, you're lying. Did it even happen at a concert?
Do you know who Dodge's real father is?
It's Lil Chubby, okay? Lil Chubby is Dodge's dad.
If we looked surprised, it was because we were. The Chubbies were the most powerful family in Camden. Lil Chubby's father, Big Chubby, owned nearly every business in town, from the dry cleaners.
You wouldn't clean your body with discount chemicals, so why should you treat your clothes any differently?
To the restaurants.
The taste of slow cooking with the sloppiest sauce around.
And when Chubby Sr. died, his empire went to his son.
Introducing the Chubby SAT Prep. Help your child achieve his dreams. And dads, while your kids study the SATs, why don't you come down and study a little TNA?
Chubby Tutorials is to SAT Prep.
As Club Chubby is to directions. Come on.
Little Chubby is Dodge's dad? Oh my God.
That explains why Dodge's mustache started growing already.
Joy, Little Chubby owns half this town. The Chubbies were the first family to have two cars. This is a gold mine. Dodge is the heir to the Chubby Empire.
It's a fool's gold mine, Earl, so you better keep your mouth shut.
Oh, why didn't you tell Little Chubby about this?
I went to tell him right when I found out I was with child, but I saw something there that scared me into praying and doing a sign of the cross, even though I'm not Catholic. Amen.
Joy said she made a list of things she was going to buy on QVC, then went to notify the man who was going to pay the bills.
Is Lil Chubby here?
You should be back any minute.
Cool, I'll wait. Give me a bottle of champagne. Not going to drink it, I just want to shake it up and pour it all over myself. One of my ovaries laid a golden egg.
Somebody here pregnant with my baby?
Well, I'm your damn right someone here is pregnant with your baby. I expect you to do something about it.
Yeah, well, I will do something about it. In this hand, I have a one-way bus ticket, and in this hand, I have a gun. Say what? Take a hand. Better hurry up. Might have a bus to catch.
I decided right then and there that I was going to raise Dodge 100% on my own.
By tricking me into marrying you? And then never working, never cooking, never cleaning, making me support you? I spent 10 days in jail for stealing you a diaper genie. Which, by the way, there's nothing magic about it. It's just crap in a bag.
It's always about you, isn't it?
You need to tell Little Chubby, Joy. I know he used to be a psycho like his late father, but after I kicked him in the nuts and disrupted his hormones, he became a kinder, gentler guy. Until his reconstructive ball surgery, after which he became a psycho again, but when he realized he liked his nice self better, he re-racked himself. I can't believe you don't remember all this. You love ball stories.
I'm not taking any chances.
But this could make Dodge's life so much better. It could make all your lives easier. And Dodge deserves to know.
Well, I'm not telling Little Chubby, okay? And you need to leave it alone.
Look, Joy. Even though Joy told me to leave it alone, little Chubby was Dodge's father. And I knew there were ways he could make Dodge's life a lot better. He could certainly hook him up with a hotter date to the prom. And maybe it could make little Chubby's life better, too.
Hey, Earl, Randy.
How'd you know it was us?
Look up.
Hey, Hickey boys. Hey, you know, I wouldn't eat those. The shrimp come from Camden Lake. If you turn out the lights, I'm not gonna lie to you. They glow.
All these shows are boring.
Well, they're not real TV shows. They're security footage. I have cameras all over town. I'll show you what I mean. Let's take a look at what's going on at Chubby's pulled pork.
Wow, that guy's putting his wiener in a hot dog bun. His real wiener.
Yeah, that's my cook. Every once in a while, he tricks somebody into putting mustard and relish on it.
Do not change the channel.
Why don't you fill us in now?
This is quite a room you built for yourself.
Used to be a butcher shop, but we shared a wall with the club, so I bought it and tricked it all out like this. And this is where I spend most of my time.
Please let me out!
Well, I didn't change everything. Sometimes a refrigerated meat locker comes in handy.
It's so cold in there!
Yeah, well, maybe next time you'll think twice before deciding to lean against my car.
Little Chubby?
What? Oh, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, why am I acting like a douchebag again? Well, there's a simple explanation for that. I'm a douchebag again.
Little Chubby told us he discovered that his business was no place for a nice guy.
I'm not trying to be disrespectful, but, boss, I think your best dancing days may be over, man.
Nah. Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey. Hello, my ragtime gal. Now, this is where I drop my bloomers and let people see all the way to Florida.
Great. Well, I guess you can start my... Well, that old prune slipped off the stripper's pole and shattered her pelvis. I swear to God, I think her vagina fell off. As you can well imagine, the customers fled in terror. Anyway, it's no way to run a business, and certainly it's not the way the old me would do it.
So you just started acting mean?
No, I tried that, but I was hormonally incapable. So I got a bowel transplant.
Get out.
Yeah, it's true. You can get any type you want. I got bowl balls. They're huge. Huge. You know, it's cool. It's a lot of fun. Occasionally, a cow will lift its tail and all hell will break loose, but, you know. What's freezing, guys? 32 degrees, right?
For the love of God!
So, what brings you fellas up?
Who, us? Oh, we just came by to show you my new watch. It's a TMX. Okay, Earl, time to go now.
Not yet, Randy. I need to tell you something. And with all that new plumbing down there, this may even be good news. In case you were worried you'd never be able to have a kid, well, you do.
First of all, as far as my plumbing goes, it's just fine. If I want to have a kid, I'll have a kid. I turn out to be a minotaur, but I'll love it none the same. Secondly, that woman said she was on the pill.
I haven't even told you who it was yet.
Yeah, don't worry. I'll tell you what I'll do. If you leave this alone, I'll leave you alone. If you don't leave this alone...
That's a flask. You're showing me a flask.
Oh, sorry about that.
Oh, I get it now.
Ew, someone sneezed on there?
Ew.
Catalina, you gotta help us. We're trying to prove little Chubby is Dodge's father, and we need something with his DNA on it.
What's DNA?
That's what makes up your spit, your blood, and your boogers. No two people's boogers are exactly alike. They're like snowflakes.
I can't help you, Earl. Little Chubby would ruin my life if he found out I was tricking him. He has cameras everywhere. I need to make it look like you're my customer. I'm gonna stick my hand down your pants, then you hand me a 20.
I don't have any cash on me. Since Catalina was too afraid of Chubby to help, me and Randy were gonna have to dig in and help ourselves.
Come on, Earl, let's get out of here.
We just need to find a cigar butt or some hair, anything that might have little Chubby's DNA.
All I see are a bunch of little balloons with mayonnaise in them.
Little Chubby, run!